Welcome back. Earlier this year, Waldenburg Village, a skilled rehabilitation and long-term care facility on the West Bank, created a multi-sensory room in their memory care unit. It was made possible through a generous donation by the Albert and Ray Hendler Charitable Trust. It's called the Snoozlin Therapy Room, and it's part of the facility's initiative to improve the quality of life for residents suffering from dementia and Alzheimer's. Waldenburg is the only healthcare facility in the state of Louisiana offering this therapy to its patients. So here to explain is the medical director at Waldenburg Village, Dr. Josh Lowentritt. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning. Thanks for having me today.
So nice to have you on. Now, for folks who are not familiar with your facility, tell me about it.
Sure. So Waldenburg is a fairly recently rebuilt facility. We have independent living apartments. We have assisted living apartments. We have a 120-bed nursing home with 20 of those beds are in our memory care unit. And those are for folks with dementing illness or Alzheimer's. We also take care of quite a number of folks who are short-term stays, who are just out of the hospital, who need additional care, additional physical therapy, and medical treatments or IV antibiotics coming out of a big hospital.
Okay, so you have this new thing, and we were chatting off camera that I'm like, oh, a therapy room, it can't be that exciting. This is actually a really, really unique concept. Tell me how this Snoozlin room came about. Where did this idea come from?
So there's an initiative nationally and statewide in regulating nursing homes to improve quality life for each of the residents there. And one of the major goals is to be able to reduce the need for medications, which we sometimes need for people when they're agitated or frightened. And sometimes those medicines are long-term medicines, but also sometimes those are just as needed. So the goal is to figure out how can we improve the quality of life of these residents who really have a very restricted quality of life.
Yeah.
So we've been fortunate to receive a tremendous grant from the Hendler Foundation, and we researched how can we do this. And our director of nursing, Veronica Hickson, looked into quite a number of different areas for therapy and found the Snoozlin therapy room being used in Europe and in other cities and other states. We were so excited to be able to bring in this therapy to our residents, and we installed it a few months ago.
Okay. Now, I was really hoping I could say this, so I'm going to, and you know I'm going to butcher it, but the name Snoozlin is derived from the Dutch words snooflin and dozlin?
Right.
And More or less.
Right. And so those are the words that the researchers combined to make Snoozlin.
Okay. Okay.
And those mean relax, excitement.
Okay. Okay. Now, tell me a little bit about these researchers and what they found kind of came about with this room.
Sure. So the therapy is used in, with different groups of patients. Obviously, it cannot be anyone with a seizure disorder because the lighting that we put in can actually induce a seizure.
Okay.
But for the demented patients, what we find is for folks who are withdrawn or somewhat lethargic, they come into the room with all of these sensory experiences. They'll have aromatherapy, there's a massage chair, we have lights and a dimmed room and different colors projected onto the walls. So you might have a fish tank projected against the walls.
And we're actually seeing pictures of that right now.
And so you can imagine how much fun it is when you go to the Aquarium of the Americas and you walk through and you see the coral reef.
Yeah.
Well, imagine if you're a person with dementia who doesn't have access to all of that. And you come into a room and let's say you were a fisherman or you used to do needlepoint or you used to garden or you used to work in your shed, but now you're in a very restricted environment and you have the opportunity to be exposed to this stimulation and sensory items that you haven't seen in a while. So they excite people who are withdrawn. We also get to see a calming behavior for people who are more agitated. And so we have people now, the residents, they're looking forward to coming into the Snoozlin therapy room during the day. So it's not just meals and watch AMC movies on old TV. And so it's really a wonderful new activity for our residents. And we're just really proud that we have it.
Yeah. Now, you mentioned this was an old TV room.
Right. This was the old TV room where the old black and white movies would play, and you'd see folks snoozing in their chairs.
And
so now it is a place where they come, their excitement, they're looking forward to it. We have seen a reduction in the need for medications for different behaviors. So there's less people who yell, they yell less frequently. People who need less medication for agitation. We've been able to reduce the doses of the medications for many of our long-term patients. And that's really beneficial because each of those medicines that may help control a behavior, they have side effects.
Always, yeah.
And so by reducing these very strong medications, we really hope we improve quality of life, reduce suffering, make this the best day we can for folks who are here.
Yeah, absolutely. Can this technology be used to treat other things? I mean, here you're talking about patients with dementia and Alzheimer's. Can it be used on children or people with other maybe mental health issues?
The therapy is used for a variety of conditions in Europe and in some of the other major centers around the country. We've installed for this specific purpose. We're very fortunate. It's been so well received that we've received additional grant funding to put up a second room in the second floor of our nursing home, which is really more of a traditional nursing home environment. People who do not have quite the degree of dementing illnesses. So we're so excited about this program.
Wow, and there's an open house coming up. If people want to check it out?
Yeah, we have an open house. We're very excited about it. We really think this is a valued asset to the community of people who really needs our services.
Okay, we're going to get all the info on your screen right now. It's Wednesday, July 20th. It's happening 11:30 a.m. until 2:30 p.m. If you want to see the Snoozlin room for yourself, you can go check it out. Maybe good for a family member of your own. Well, really, really fascinating stuff, and I'm so glad to hear it's going
great.
Well.
Great. Thanks so much for your time today.
Thanks for coming on. And for more information regarding Waldenburg Village and the Snoozlin therapy room, log on to our website, wgno.com, click on the 411. We'll also have info about that open house up there.